back, everybody. And this time, okay, really, let's tell Screw not do that. Anyways, welcome back, everybody. And here's a little continuation after Mega Man X1. Here we're playing Mega Man X2, and our story begins. It has been 6 months since the destruction signal. And, however, the start of the signal is over. Mega Man X and the new generation of the Maverick Hunters have yet to destroy all of the signals involved. Live by information game by Dr. K, Mega Man X. Oh my god, that goes by so fast. I don't even have time for Rames. Fuck this shit. Nah, we got time for Rames. I don't really like this whole sequence. Hey, well, guess who that is back? That was Green Biker Dude. And he's dead. Damn, how tragic. Shit. Oh my god. I thought he could draw me in there. He was wrong.
Comes this new boss, which is pathetically easy, but I mean, I know it's the first boss of the game, but even then, it could be the same, at least not saying new as much. I was like, man, it looks like something out of that Robots movie. Look how much damage you took from one charge shot. I'm hitting him with these little mini lemons and he's dying.
This is their leader. His name is Mega Man X.
Those who underestimate him are now nothing but scrap, I guess he said.
We won't make the same mistake. He is powerful, but he is blind to what is happening around him. Our Mavericks will keep him busy until we are ready. Yes, how is the plan proceeding? Collections is proceeding as scheduled. However, we are having problems with the control chip. We have little time. We must finish construction on schedule.
We must hurry. Construction of what, I wonder? We'll figure it out soon enough. Now, these day rabbits are quite different from the ones in the first game. We have a wire sponge, morph moth, flame stag, magna centipede, crystal snail, probably the worst of the bunch along with, wheel gator, bubble crab, and overdrive ostrich. Now, I'd say either flame stag or maybe overdrive ostrich might be my favorite, but I know where we're going to start first. A wire sponge stage for one very specific reason, which is honestly a really lame reason, I might add, but it helps out with most of the game as is. And that is, it's a secret up here. Just an instant heart piece that you'll never find intentionally. Like, you'd have to accidentally stumble upon that. I genuinely don't like that placement. But, whatevs. Kind of reminds me of those frog enemies from Astro Man stage. Now, there's these little weather vanes over here. And I think if you hit them with certain weapons, certain weather effects happen. But we don't have any weapons right now. And this is taking forever to break. Alright, it's broken. Now. Yay. My favorite. I'm just dead from spikes. Oh my god. Ah! No, no you don't. No you don't. Oof. I gotta use the dash. Okay. No. Wow. Yeah, this is why I don't like skinny platforms. Whatever. Maybe you can redo that. Let's try that again. Seriously, whose bright idea was to make these platforms so small? It's just like the first game. Wow, a lot of floating platforms are way too small to land on, in my opinion. Already out of HP. Jesus Christ. You get on the thing, dude. It's not hard. Good placement. And the rain is back, yay! And I'm already out of HP, what the shit. And there probably weren't even any checkpoints nearby either. Okay, there was a checkpoint. Oh yeah, look at this. Cheap drink. Real cheap drink. Really? I better just put this on rookie. I don't know. This is dumb. Oh my god, get out of my way. Jeez, the game seems a lot better when I'm not getting pelted by everything every second. I can actually take a few freaking hits and I'm losing half my health bar in 2 minutes. Oh wow, cheap trick game. Boss room. You had to get here on this mode. Because I am sucking. Nah, I haven't played this game nearly as much as the first game. Okay, so here we go. Wire sponge. Probably one of the weirdly designed mavericks I've ever seen. I mean, how is he a sponge exactly? That confused me a bit, I'm gonna be honest. And of course, I just lose half my HP right there. Nice. I should have these patterns because I never gave it enough time to practice them. Don't care, I want to progress. We're already 15 minutes into this and I haven't even passed one stage besides the intro. It's so much better when you're not getting frickin' turn over like a tree. Oh shoot, goddamn rest of the tough. He's angry now. You won't like him when he's angry. And I literally stood still and he didn't hit me. He's angry again, guys. Besides Crystal Hunter, that weapon really sucks. I say the music in X Tier isn't nearly as good as the music in the first X game. That's still. Now this little screen is definitely pretty cool. You got Strike Chain! Definitely is pretty slow. Alright, which means this extension stage is pretty cool. It takes place on Rome Lake City. I'm gonna at least try to get the ones like the other one. And with that fast paced the extension is supposed to be, I don't like those enemies take like 6 hits to die. Oh, these guys take 3 hits quite clearly, and they're also one of the few enemies in this game that are affected by the Crystal Hunter weapon. No, we inevitably get that weapon. We'll test that later, but here is our illustrious use for Strike Chain. And honestly, I haven't seen this shit in this in a while. It takes a lot of practice to get this right, but ah, damn it, I almost had it actually. Oh my god. Jesus, this is as bad as a freaking Arc Tank from Spark Mandrill stage. At least that enemy's never fun if you ever need unlimited, weapon energy. That's about it. I don't wanna go down there. Jesus. You do me a favor and die, thank you. Pressing the dash button, and she's not dashing. Why is he not dashing? Wait, can you not dash on these platforms? I'm clearly dashing, so I wonder why he's not dashing. Yes. Better just look at the video how it is. I just don't remember how to do this. I'm gonna die, thank you. This is pissing me off. Actually, I might have legit found the angle for that. Turn around, dude. Yeah, I genuinely don't remember how the hell you're supposed to do this. I don't know how the fuck you're supposed to get that. Hold on, give me a second. No, I think we need the leg parts for that one, so I just wasted all this time for literally no reason. Oh yeah, we're gonna need the leg parts for that. Oh, that was a waste. And then your structure, which I think we can still use. No reason. Yeah, I just sat there and wasted that. If y'all want to skip ahead, go on ahead. Anyways, time to make up for that a little bit. With some good old-fashioned gameplay. Which we'll come get another time. But I might have just noticed. I think, yeah, I kind of jumped over that one. And I gotta say, this is all over. This is fun. Jesus Christ, the game balance is kind of really great this one. Actually, if I remember correctly, there is a reward up there, but I don't remember what that was. I don't know if I'm not sure of the enemies in the first game. These guys actually can be unarmed. No, it's just a life. We don't need a life. So I don't have to use it too many times. I don't even know where the hell I'm going right now. This is a random thing to pop back here. Initially, when I first played this game, I thought this was blood, but no, it's not blood, it's just oil. Just oil. We can keep this. Still, at least ready to see. Alright, I do have quite a bit of problems with this fight. I just don't like how long he stays in the oil. Just drags out the fight way long. Oh yeah, and that stupid attack. This is fair. Now, honestly, his weakness honestly makes this fight longer, because he'll always go back into the oil and just tactics reset each and every time. Look at that. And this pattern resets, you know, because I really don't like fighting. Wheelbeater, we are not going to do that. So look at that, look how quickly he goes into the frickin' whatamacallit. It's just not a fun fight in my opinion. He's just constantly hiding under the oil, or the totally not blood. And then this stupid attack that's basically impossible to dodge. I mean, Structure does some pretty decent damage to it, it looks like. Other than that. Like I didn't just press the dash button there. I was not within that target range. This fight's just tedious at best. This fight is pretty tedious. I don't like how tedious this fight can be. I just said the word tedious 3 times in a row. Tedious, tedious, tedious. Dude, fuck off. Seriously, just. Okay. Watch it go right back into the blood. I just spent way too much time down there for my liking. I don't like it. And this tedium is over. Exactly how I like the first game, I haven't really played this one too much. Well, now, I won't end off the episode just yet like I normally would around this halfway mark. Because you got Spin Wheel! Spin Wheel actually has some interesting properties to it. It's more than just, well, moving wheel that cuts you. There's a certain area in Morph Moth stage. Okay, wait. Never mind. Exposition. I see now why Sigma fell at the hands of Mega Man X. He is quite formidable. Yes, he had loads of trouble fighting an alligator. Nah, he fought that alligator just fine. Am I not sure our Mavericks can hold him long enough? We may have to intervene. Alright, these guys I'm totally doing Alright, Rookie Hunter on. Dr. Kane, what happened?
A group of Mavericks calling themselves the X-Hunters have just contacted us.
Greetings. We have all of Zero's parts.
Yeah, they can be yours if you can defeat us.
We look forward to meeting you, X.
X, Zero's control chip is still stored here. I doubt it is possible to resurrect him without it.
Dr. Kane, I've got to get Zero. His parts back. At any cost. And so we gotta get Zero's parts back now as well. Like I even wanted to be bothered with that. Now I don't want to spoil what happened if you don't get his parts. But you don't have to really get all of his parts to, well, complete the game. You don't have to get him, period. Even. Man, where the hell is Morph Moth stage? That's where one of them are hiding, so we're gonna go there next. As well as what I was saying before, with the spin wheel, it can actually cut through certain terrains and unlock even more secrets. Morph Moth isn't weak to spin wheel, he's weak to speed burner, which you get from Flame Stag. But we're not gonna fight Flame Stag just yet. Thank you. And here's the secret. Now let's talk about this spin wheel, if you would move so kindly. And here's the secret that spin wheel does reveal. Da-da-da-da! A capsule!
Mega Man X, enter the capsule.
This enhancement will modify your body armor.
With it, you can absorb damage and transfer it into explosive weapon energy.
And now we have the body parts to a new armor set. Not like the first armor in the first game, but this is considered the second armor. It definitely looks better than the first armor, in my opinion. But it may not be as powerful. And now I can take twice the damage. Perfect. This is actually a pretty suitable upgrade for things. And this doesn't look quite right. My boss is actually pretty decent enough. Takes a little bit of patience to hitting him, but other than that, hard hitting because you have to weaken that and start hitting this little fly thing. Something that kind of resembles a dragonfly. Dragonfly looking thing is dead now. You don't need it anymore. Oof. The same mid-boss we fought earlier, but this time with that little magnetic field going on. Actually, that's an interesting depth to this fight, I suppose. Actually, we don't need that. And all these damn flies here.
And I just had to dash through all of these. Oh yeah, I remember when Hex Hunter was here. Fuck it, we're not fighting him. I guess we're fighting Zero at the end of the game. Because... unless... we're not fighting Zero. Because in order to get Zero's body part, you gotta find a secret exit that only can be acquired. We go to the stage where the Maxon turns. And you have to be in a fight, which literally you get one chance for, so you can't run out of time. I might even just get this over there or something. Alright, seriously, we're gonna work fairly. See, I'm more from off the bed, actually. Very learnable pattern, very. Easy. Aside from that laser attack he has in the second phase, not a lot of annoying stuff to worry about. Thank you.
if it does. Now. And now, this way can be taken a little bit higher. That's the laser taken. Okay. Of course you fucking do that. Alright, never mind. Because I fucking take contact and take like half my HP just down. Dead, Morphmas. Give me your power. And we got Suction. That does not look like a thing of silk. That looks like some weird rocks and dirt. And I think that's where we're trying to end this episode off. And now Agile is completely off the map. How fun. I think we should go to Magnuson for the next one. This is about to suck shot. So that's a fair one to do too. Well, that was the episode, man. First episode of Mega Man X2. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed what you saw, please comment, like, subscribe, follow, do whatever you do to support this channel. Thank you for watching, and see y'all next time.